Are you ready for a confession?
Yeah, of course I am. Let's
do it. Are you ready for a confession? Are you really?
Let's welcome Simon, Matt and Susie from Greatest Hits Radio Drive Time. Here they come.
Mayo, Simon Mayo, Greatest Hits Radio.
Take a seat, guys.
Look, it's not Thank just you. Simon Mayo, we've got Susie and Matt as well. Welcome along.
Just to be absolutely clear, it's Susie in the pink, who's tried and made an effort, and it's Matt in the AC/DC t-shirt, who has not tried at all.
No effort at all.
No, for those at the back, it's not Bruce Dickinson, sorry.
So, Simon, here yes. we are, the part of the show that I was really looking forward to.
Good.
Please give us the name of today's confessor.
Yes, certainly. Well, we just had a little conversation backstage, and the name of the person who is going to confess tonight is Martin Kemp.
What?
Martin Kemp is, by popular demand... Now, are you happy to confess?
Yeah, I mean,
let's face it, there'll be an awful lot of stuff. Susie and Matt will sit in judgment, Kate will sit in judgment, and you will sit in judgment as well.
Clean as you like, Martin.
I'm sure you've lived a blameless life.
I have, absolutely. What am I confessing?
I think, well, it's a story from when you were on tour, and it involves a hotel room. I'll leave you to...
I know exactly where you're going with this.
Okay, so...
And I don't think it's clean enough to put on the London Palladium stage, but I will tell it anyway, right? So it's, all right, it's 1986, right? And Spandau are recording in the famous Musicland Studios, where you know, loads of great bands have been, like Led Zeppelin and Queen. Queen recorded loads of stuff there. So we wanted to go over to Musicland in Munich to record our fourth album, which was Parade. And 1986 was the time when, you know, when they changed over hotel room keys from the metal, big metal thing that you had with the keychain and everything, to the cards, the plastic cards, which were absolutely brilliant at the time. So anyway, we finished recording one night. We go to this nightclub called the P1, if you remember it, P1 in Munich. Anyway, big nightclub amongst bands. And we go there and we get completely rat-arsed. Completely. There's no other way to put it. And so 3 o'clock in the morning, we all come rolling back to the hotel that is connected to the studio called the Arabella. And I come into the room, into the hotel, into the foyer, get in the lift, and I go up to my room. Get to my room, and I pull out my key card, and I touch it on the door, and the thing goes to green, and it pops open. I go, you know, I've been out on a big night here, so the first thing I want to do is go into the loo. Now, this is where it shouldn't be at the London Palladium, right? But I go into the loo, and I'm sitting down on the toilet. Yep, just finished my business.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. And well, you asked me. No. just finished my business, and I'm looking round, and on the shelf, I can see someone else's toiletry.
Oh no.
And now, over underneath the sink, I can see somebody else's trousers, and somebody else's dress. And all of a sudden, I can hear snoring. And I'm thinking, what the f*** am I going to do?
It wasn't Tony Hadley's room, was it?
So I'm standing, you know, I pull my trousers up and I'm looking down at what I've left. And I'm thinking, I've got a choice here. You know, I either flush it, Or I leave it and I walk out the room. Now, at this point, I'm going to hand it over to you. What would you do? Give me a cheer if you would flush it.
Yes!
So you're going to wake everybody up?
Yes!
All right, so give me a cheer if you would just run.
Yes!
Exactly, that is exactly what I did. That's my confession.
Wow.
I thought you were going to say you signed it and then...
No, but because I run, I always felt really guilty because I kind of starved someone of a great anecdote from finding me in there.
Yeah, well, we'll get... And is that genuinely the only story from Spandau on the Road that you're prepared to tell us?
No, you can ask me anything.
Okay. Anyway, that was shocking enough for tonight's confession. Susie, what are we going to forgive? I'll come to you in just a moment. Are you going to forgive Martin?
Well, I understand the dilemma, but I just think, who wants to see that in the morning when they wake up? Yeah, and then they're going to know someone's left it.
But if I flushed it, it'd wake them up, and then it'd cause a terrible scene.
But at least they'd have a story. Yeah, but I'm sorry, Martin. I can't
wake me up
you.
Before you go-go.
Yeah, they'd just be blaming each other.
And then there'd be a story the next day in the Mail. Tony Hadley leaves a big poo in the toilet. Yeah. I saw that Tony Hadley in my bedroom. Matt.
Yay!
Matt.
Well, I'm going to forgive. Because
surprise.
Yeah, because I always forgive. I always forgive. But I'm going to forgive because, well, two things. One is, who leaves their trousers in the toilet? No one leaves their trousers. They're clearly odd. The people living in that hotel room, a little bit odd. But also, I've stayed in a few hotel rooms myself, Martin, and I've found stuff in the toilet that's far worse than even a member of Spandau Ballet could leave in the toilet. So, for that reason, I choose to forgive.
Oh,
okay, well,
listen,
don't get carried away with yourselves here, Drive Team, because tonight it's not just Simon and the team that are giving out forgiveness. We're offering a palladium pardon. So, it's whether or not the crowd here are on your side. So, if you think Martin deserves a full pardon, give him a cheer. You ain't no sinner. What do you think, Father Simon?
I think he's Martin Kempe can do what he wants.
I think that is the moral of this modern tale, don't you?
Oh. Could have been a lot worse.
Oh, listen, Simon, Susie and Matt, thank you so much for joining us, I think.
Let's hear it for Simon and the Drive Team, everyone. Thank you, gang.
Greatest Hits Radio Live.
With Holiday Inn Express.